High Court sitting in Abuja struck out a suit challenging the eligibility of Governor Obaseki for the Edo governorship election, citing certificate forgery. In the suit filed by Mr. Edoba Williams, Ugbezia Abudu, and Ahmedu Dauda Anaku on the 29th of May 2020, he accused Obaseki of forging his Bachelor of Arts certificate in Classic Studies from the University of Ibadan. When the case came up for hearing today, neither the defendants nor the plaintiff showed up, which led Justice Arnold Lee Chikere to strike it out. Why Governor Obaseki received his certificate of return from the People's Democratic Party, PDP, on Saturday. The certificate was issued by the PDP National Chairman, Uche Sekundus, in Abuja, the nation's capital. But some members of the PDP are not happy about Mr. Governor Obaseki's emergence. They have their reasons, and tonight we'll dig into that matter. What are the reasons for them being unhappy about Governor Obaseki's emergence as a flag bearer of the PDP in Edo State? Let's get to it, everyone. And let me introduce my panel tonight for you. I have in our Abuja studio Mr. Kasim Afegbua. He's a member of the PDP in Edo State, a former commissioner, and he was a spokesperson of the PDP presidential campaign organization in 2019. And from Benin, he's a member of the party, Mr. Anthony Ehilebo, is a lawyer and a member of the PDP in Edo State. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining us tonight. Let me begin. Mr. Afegbua, you wrote and you in an interview, you were reported to have said that you are not in support of Mr. Obaseki's emergence. What are your reasons?
Well, thank you, Sheung. I believe that Nigerian democracy has to follow a pattern of due process, a pattern of rule of law, a pattern of respecting guidelines, rules and regulations spread out in any process. And don't forget that Obaseki joined the PDP within 24 hours, and before you see Jack Robinson, the primaries that were primed to take place on the 19th and 20th were now postponed to on the 25th, and before you see Jack Robinson in another 5 days, virtually the three aspirants stepped down for him. For me, that is like climbing a tree from the top, because the party members and stakeholders were not adequately consulted, procedures were not followed, sales of nomination form had closed, screening had closed, virtually everything had closed when he came in. And so our point is that you don't surrender the entire structure of the party to newcomers, whereas those who have been on ground, who have been members of the party, those who have shown some loyalty and all of that, should have something on the table. And that's why I'm of the opinion that a deputy governorship candidate should have been ceded to the party, so that that would be like compensation for those who have been loyal. But that didn't happen. So both the deputy governorship candidate, both the governorship candidate, everything ceded to Obaseki. And when you ask the question, what you hear is that, oh, he's got state funds to dispense with, he's got funding to prosecute elections. That's not my own understanding of democracy. Members, electorate, and those who have shown some loyalty to party must have an aspect of the bargain that they will hold on to. Not necessarily you ceding and surrendering everything, the whims and caprices of the party to him.
We saw that footage of the handover of from the former acting national chairman of the APC, Mr. Victor Gyadom, to the caretaker chairman, Mr. Mala Buni, the governor of Yobe State. In that, you were reported to have also criticized the way and manner the crisis of the APC, where your former principal, Adams Oshiomhole, was also affected. What is your view on that matter?
I don't have a problem with whatever that has happened in APC. That's their internal problems. Of course, the contest for 2023 will factorize quite a number of issues, and the persons who will preside over the party. It's a ruling party. You should expect to have all manners of internal contestation of ideas, internal squabbling for positions and what have you. So whatever becomes the outcome of the APC, that's their internal business. If they feel that they need to get their politics right, so that they can get their governance right, all well and good for them. But what I want from the APC is for the president to sit down and govern the country and save all the hassles of all manners of economic woes and downturn that we are experiencing presently in the era of the COVID-19 pandemic. So the,
if you take the APC as a party,
and you look at the government they run, you see that there's too much of disconnection. There's too much of this disconnections in the way and manner they are running the party. And so I don't have a problem with that, that they can do anything they want to do. But my own party, the PDP, processes that are leading to the emergence of political candidates and what have you, must follow due process so that people can see us differently. We can't be behaving like APC, and in the final analysis, you expect us to be criticizing APC, whereas we are doing what APC is doing, or even doing worse things than what APC is doing. So I'm not trained like that. I'm trained to interrogate processes. I'm trained to interrogate
procedures. I'm trained to
ask questions. I won't become a dormant member of any political party.
All right,
APC.
Let me bring in Mr. Ehilebo. Mr. Ehilebo, you heard what Mr. Fegbua said about the process leading to the emergence of Governor Obaseki. What are your thoughts or how would you react to what he said?
Well, thank you for this opportunity. My Egbon, Kasim Fegbua, is someone I hold very high regard. But unfortunately, this is a time which I must disagree vehemently with him. He has alluded to the fact that I read his interview today, and I must say that I don't think I'm disappointed. I think for the level of which he can speak for a party, I think at the level which APC is in Edo State now, they need somebody of his caliber to be able to defend the candidate that they are presenting to their Edo people. Governor Obaseki is a gold mine for PDP. Like I said the last time I was in here, as Christmas come early for the PDP, the South-South block of the country is complete today as a complete PDP block. And we're very happy for that move. He complains of the process that he came into the party. Of course, I think right now he's crying more than the grief, because all the three aspirants all stepped down and all on national TV was aired live. Nobody was cajoled, nobody was compelled. They all freely and willingly stepped down for Governor Obaseki to carry on the work that he has been doing in Edo State. So when I see my big brother saying that he doesn't agree with the party, I must remind him that he came to meet us in the party. We accommodated him. In the same way Governor Obaseki came to, that we accommodated him. When he came into the party, he was made a spokesman for the presidential aspirant, Vice President Abubakar. I don't think party members cried all over the place saying that somebody who came into the party was made a spokesman for the president. So it's the same thing. I think he maybe wants to take a trip to Edo State and see the jubilation, see the faces of people that are sure that Governor Obaseki can continue the work that he has started in Edo State. And coming from someone who worked with the now erstwhile chairman of APC, who is willing to go and work for, as he has said this morning, that he's going to work for the candidate, on behalf of the PDP, I wish him good luck. I wish him well. That's the best we can wish for him. But if he doesn't fail to account for the people of Edo State and what they want, it might just be that we have an unfortunate impact here, and we have nothing more to do than to wish him well.
Let's take a breather. But when we come back, we go back to our Abuja studio where Mr. Afegbua feels that he probably will work against the candidate of his party. Whether or not that is anti-party activity, he will talk more, and we hear also a reaction from Mr. Ehilebo. That's going to be next on the program, everyone. Thank you so much, everyone. Let's get back to the conversation. My partner tonight, Mr. Kasim Afegbua, a member of the PDP and the former spokesperson of the PDP presidential campaign organization in the 2019 presidential election, and also Mr. Anthony Ehilebo, a lawyer and a member of the PDP in Edo State. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for coming on. Let me get your reaction, Mr. Afegbua. Did you mean that you were going to work against Governor Obaseki, who is now a member of your party and a candidate of your party in Edo State? you made a reference that you're not going to work with Governor Obaseki. Are you saying you're going to work against him? He's a candidate of your party, and as a member of the PDP, you do realize that?
Well, let me quickly correct the impression of my brother, Antonio Hilebo. I rejoined the PDP in 2018, July, to be specific, and I didn't become spokesman by accident because I didn't join immediately and I became a spokesman. I was part and parcel of the power process. I supported the aspiration of someone, and in the final analysis where we lost out in Port Harcourt, we were called together, and for obvious reasons, they accommodated us to be part of the spokesman of the campaign. So that is that. It is not my position on Obaseki. Is not born out of desperation. It's not born out of greed. It's not born out of money politics. My position on Obaseki is born out of the fact that there has to be a difference in the way and manner that democracy is run in this country. Someone cannot just join your party within 24 hours, you surrender every whims and caprices of the party to him, and then you sit back and tell me that you are celebrating your Christmas early enough in the day. I'm not going to be part of that process. I hold the right to vote, to hold my vote, and to vote whoever I want. And I have said it categorically that I will vote for the opposition candidate. And I don't have any apology to render anyone with respect to that. If you feel that is anti-party activity, that is your business. If you want to remove me from the party, you want to suspend me, you want to expel me, that's your business. You cannot suspend my vote. You can suspend my membership of party. So for me, I don't like pretenses. I don't pretend about situations, about scenarios, about persons. You cannot surrender a party to someone who just joined you because you feel that he has resources to dispense with. These are not his resources. These are state resources. And as a stakeholder in Edo, I have the right to interrogate the processes that led to his emergence. I have to be consulted. I have to buy into the material or into the candidate.
Mr. Fegua,
to present to the electorate.
Mr. Fegua,
putting me to campaign at my village.
If I may, but in apologies,
to my followers and all of that.
Let me quickly ask you. There's a quick one. It's the fact that so that for our viewers to understand, your anger tonight or your grievance about Mr. Obaseki's emergence, is it born out of the fact that you were not consulted, or about the fact that you do not like the process? Because it does look like a similar thing is not only happening on your own party; it's happening elsewhere too.
Yes, well, it's not about being consulted. Whether we like it or not, there were procedures that were laid out with respect to the emergence of party candidates. You have to buy nomination form. You have to canvass for votes. We did congresses. We elected delegates. I was an elected delegate, you know, under the PDP and all of that. Only for us to do 24 hours for the primaries to be postponed, and before you see Jack Robinson, everybody is stepping down and all of that. That to me is an aberration.
Let's get Mr. Hilebo back, Mr. Fegua. Mr. Hilebo, how would you react to this? You've heard some of the things that Mr. Fegua said and the reason why he thinks that things are not done right. Your reaction, please.
It's really interesting that he says that a lot of things are not done right, and he's going to support a candidate that came in almost the same way, left PDP less than a couple of months ago, and is now the aspirant. It doesn't make sense. Every argument
we'll try to reconnect with Mr. Ayila, but I guess we're having some network issues there. But Mr. Fegua, what do you say about the principle of politics and democracy, which says that the views of the majority? It does look like you are in the minority, aren't you?
Well, you have not carried out any assessment to determine whether this is a majority view or this is a minority view.
there are quite a number of persons
who are also sharing the same kind of sentiment that I have expressed here. There are
sorry, Mr. Fegua, let me get Mr. I understand because of the network issues, Mr. Ilebo is here so that we can have a fair and balanced timing in our conversation. Mr. Ilebo, thank you are here. So your reaction quickly.
It's very interesting that my big brother here is alluding to the fact that things were not done right in PDP. I mean, everything was done right. Everything was done by the books. It was like you said, it's a minority. I really just want to really mention that this is a well man, is a former boss. I think this is about. It's not that he has any justification for him saying that he's going to do play the role of a spoiler or an antipathy. Everybody that goes to that is governor's baby. He's been showing all sorts that the governor has been spending money here and there. I haven't seen that money. I was a delegate to the primary. I haven't seen any money there because the governor, in fact, where everything is not as free as we thought we'd be using some things for the boys that have been working. That's the opinion. And I find surprising that he says that he joined the party in July 2018. And by September, October, when he took the presidential, he was already spokesman. I've been in the party. I never left the party. I wasn't presidential spokesman. So if we're giving him those privileges as a party member, he should also accept it when he's given to others. The person he's saying he's going to support in APC, we don't even know whether his name has been submitted. We don't even know the state of the party that he's in. And you want to go and support that person against the wishes of the people? Well, I wish him luck. I mean, he's also showing loyalty against the boss. So we don't expect anything more from him. But all that I will say is that he doesn't speak for the aspirants themselves who stepped down. He's saying that we should have offered the death people. But don't forget that that ticket came as the ballpark deal. And we needed to leave that ticket intact so that they can finish their mandate. For that reason, I'm from Edo Central. And we're looking at the governor doing his four years that he left, and then all should shift to us. If that is the arrangement that works for Edo people, I think that it should be respected. And the Edo leaders, all the Edo leaders, the two senators, the House of Rep members we have were all brought into the acceptance of the government to the party. So if my big brother is insisting that he wants to vote for his candidate, that's his choice. But I'll assure you, majority of the Edo people know who they are going to vote for come September 19th. They know that they are going to vote for continuity of the project that has started all across the state. He cannot say to me that the governor is not performing. The governor is perhaps giving instances. And that is why PDP saw him as a beautiful bride that they needed to cut at this point in time. Again, saying that one or two people may have their differences, but he's not speaking as an interested party. The people that should be speaking as a chosen party, I remember the last time I was on the show.
So, Mr. Ilebo, we need to close the program. We are obviously out of time, but Mr. Fegua, in 20 seconds, let's get your final thoughts.
Well, I thank Mr. Ilebo for his views, but you should also remember that barely 2 months, 3 months ago, where the PDP in the states called Obaseki F9 in all the critical sectors of the Edo economy with respect to failed promises, poor performance, and what have you. It's on record that the PDP took him to the cleaners with respect to failed promise of job creation of 200,000 that is not anywhere to be seen, and so many other aspects of Edo, of the Edo narrative. I'm not going to go into all of those details. All I have said is that at least I'm bold enough to come out in the open that I won't support Obaseki. It would have been different if I was hiding and I was pretending to be supporting him, and I'll be doing some damages.
So, Mr. Fegua, I must sincerely thank you, and as well as Mr. Anthony Ilebo, a member of the PDP, both of them. Thank you so much for your thoughts tonight. And that's how much we can serve you tonight on the program. Thank you, everyone, indeed, for watching. I'm Shaw Kimale.